I am Vishan Asan Khan.
And my name is Akshay Veerkar.
From River Yamuna. We are going to, before giving any hits, we will say something. So who is the king? Currently he is the king of the telecom industry. So game of phones.
So our topic is disruptive marketing strategy of Jio. So let me ask you a question. How many of you were there in the distribution of the free SIM card of free Jio? How many of you there in the field?
How many of you there in the line collecting Jio free SIMs? We have some videos of yours.
Yeah, actually, the hands are not so much, but there were so many bigger lines because I was going there at 10 a.m. and I came back for to 4 p.m. at least.
So, wash yourselves. You are here. Let's see. Play. So people were complaining during demonetization, but they didn't complain anything when they were standing in the queues for more than 2 to 3 hours.
Just because it was free.
So here is the content. We are going to give some introduction. We'll throw some lights on market share of different companies, pre and post Jio launch, market share of different mobile manufacturing companies, revenue, competitor analysis, marketing strategy, SWOT analysis, and finally the conclusion.
Introduction part. So in introduction part, I would like to introduce the name of the company. It is Reliance Jio Infocom Limited, that is mainly known as Jio only. And the main parental company is Reliance Industry, that is have a very good hand in the stock market, and all of us have known about Mr. Mukesh Ambani. So it was an advantage for that particular Jio brand, right? And the Mukesh Ambani is founder, and it was founded in 2007. And it is based in Navi Mumbai.
So the technology which they use is based on voice over long term evolution, that is VoLTE.
And known as 4G.
Okay. The reason why I chose this topic is because when Jio introduced, I was staying in hostel and I used to do recharge of more than 500 rupees in order to talk to my parents and in order to get the data. Previously, they were charging around the competitors, they were charging around 400 to 300 rupees for just 1 GB data. So it was very difficult for the hostelites to manage their expenses and to manage everything and even to manage the calls and voice and everything. So when Jio introduced, it suddenly the life became easy. My expenses were reduced. They were giving in 399 they were giving free data 1.5 GB of data per day, and they were providing with unlimited calls for next 3 months.
Actually, what they are doing at earlier existing company were charging for the voice calls, like 70% to 80% of revenue of the earlier company which are existing, like Airtel, Idea and Vodafone. They were charging for the voice call only, and from that particular revenue, Mr. Mukesh Ambani found some new technologies like VoLTE. He was just charging for the data, and that was very less amount. Actually, we have 130 crores of population in India, and 105 crores are their mobile user. But actual data user was only 10% of them, right? So he found that if anyone can provide the data in large number, in an economical rupees, like. So he can rule the telecom industry if you can provide the data at a low cost, right? It was known by the money only.
So basically what he did was there was a the market was saturated. Companies like Vodafone, Idea, they were ruling the industry, and most of their revenues, 60 to 70% of the revenues, were coming from the voice calls. Ambani was a very smart guy, so he knew if he wants to succeed in telecom industry, he has to do something new. So what he did, he created a new segment. When he launched Jio, only 10%, as my friend mentioned, only 10% of the users were using 4G, and we are the population of 130 crores of people, and then 105 crores of people were using phone, and just the small number, 10% of them were using 4G. So he created a new segment. The technology that Vodafone and Idea and other competitor were using was purely 2G and 3G. There were no new technology. So he was very smart. He comes with a new technology. He directly jumps into the 4G segment. He created a new customer base, 4G customer base. So what market strategy did he use was acquisition, that is loss leading strategy, activation, retention, referral, and revenue.
In acquisition strategy, what he was doing, he was distributing the free SIM so that he just acquires the people, he just increases number of clients who will be using the SIM. Okay, and this was the actual scenario. He was distributing the free SIM, and we were in the huge number of lines there. For the activation of that SIM, earlier we used to give our previous number. We used to wait for the 2 days or 3 days for the activation of SIM. But after that, the Jio came. He just started some new evolution. Like he just giving, he just asking for the Aadhaar number and giving activated SIM card in 15 minutes or half an hour at least. Right.
So basically, then companies were focusing on free call. Companies were focusing on calls, SMS, and roaming. He didn't focus on all of these. He was providing this freely. His main focus was on data. According to him, data is a new oxygen. So he was completely focused on data, and he created a new, he focused on this strategy, the what we call as razor and blade strategy, or gun or bullet strategy, printer or ink strategy, game or city strategy. Basically, what it is, if you buy a razor, you have to buy a blade at any cost, or if you want shave, GG sir will kick you out, everybody except me. So printer and ink, if you buy a CD and game, you have to buy a CD. If you buy a game, you have to buy a CD. So likewise, when he introduced Jio SIM, he also introduced various Jio products such as mobile phone.
Like Jio mobile phone. He was the first one who introduced the Jio phone that was having 4G. Earlier, rest of the companies of mobile having only 2G or 3G. And the specifically 4G network was just because of 4G network was introduced by Ambani, so he introduced the 4G support phone also.
So this is the chart. We picked it from Statista. So this is the pre and post Jio launch. Before Jio launch, Aircel was acquiring around 8.6% of the data, of the market. Idea and Vodafone were acquiring around 19 and 17% respectively. After the post Jio launch, Reliance Jio suddenly acquired the 19.6% of the market. That is a huge number of market he acquired. And Airtel, Vodafone, and Idea, they started losing customers. It is noted that Reliance Jio has gained 8 million subscribers in just 3 weeks and 1.5 million subscribers in the recent April month. So this is also a money tap in the phone market. This is the future phones and this is the smartphones. Jio, in 2017, Jio tapped around 11% of the market, and in 2018, it tapped around 38% of the market. So the products that are offered are Reliance 4G broadband, live smartphones, Jio Net Wi-Fi, Jio Phone, Jio Apps. Revenue. Based on this recent Q3 results, it reported around 10,400 crores of revenue.
And the recent in the recent revenue result, he have crossed the 11,000 also. 11,000 crores.
This is the competitor analysis. Jio covers around 25% of the overall data, whereas Airtel 23.6 and Vodafone 34.1 and others 21.1 crores. This is the short analysis. The strength of the... Thank you.